Similar to that, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
But you'd be thinking, it took me 5 years to get to Europe, you know, like
yeah,
I can't.
Sorry, yeah. Totally different level.
No, but the same. No. Same importance to each person.
Exactly. for your son, you know, he's thinking, man, like I've nearly nailed that trick. I've been working on it for 2 months. You know, that's what – everything's an investment. Like, you know, these things, you work and you train and to succeed at whatever you do in whatever discipline. And then when it's just shattered, like taken away, like an injury – broken leg, you know, people break femurs and these things are big injuries. Like you're sitting on the couch.
But what happens? Like, say, okay, so you broke your collarbone. Obviously, your doctor made it stronger. But if you had another fall that hit that again, and because you know how sometimes injuries are so bad that they just won't heal.
Yeah.
If that happens, that kind of ruins your career.
Yeah, well, collarbones are different. Like you would...
Okay, collarbone was a bad example.
No, but I know what you're saying.
Yeah.
No, there is that... That is the hard thing. Like there's a lot of athletes that, you know, they break their femur.
Yeah.
And that's huge. Yeah. Like that's the biggest bone in your body. So then they come back early. And like you said, next minute infection and all this stuff. And it just leads down that path. But that's a good thing with Steve is he's like, no, this is possible. Like... Collarbone is one of the, like, my opinion, I don't know what it's there for. Like, they should pull them out so I can't break the things because they just seem to break so easy.
I bet you're not the only one. Imagine how many people have thought that in sport. Oh,
look at Tour de France. The guy comes down the hill, washes the front end out, and breaks the collarbone. Maybe they can make, collarbones.
Artificial ones for people collarbones. Like you.
Or just, like, a shock absorber in there. Like.
I'll bet you $100 someone's already working on that.
Yeah,
but it has... Yeah, it wouldn't need a shock absorber, though, because that's probably why it's so fragile. It's because if it wasn't fragile, you'd probably do more damage. It might go, like... You know, stab through the shoulder and all that. Because the shoulder's quite a complicated joint, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the thing. Breaking bones and the way I speak like that, it's nothing. Like, you know, you break your wrist and it's 6 weeks and cut the plaster off. If you go again, when that 6 weeks sounds like a long time when you're in that position, I've had 12 weeks in moon boots and stuff and this kind of stuff and it's a long time, but when you do ligaments, I did ligaments in my ankle, and that was insane. I just thought I sprained my ankle. Yeah. Next minute, I'm in the moon boot for 13 weeks, no weight bearing.
Yeah.
Like it's
getting fat, feeling awkward and yuck.
Yeah.
And the rehab too. The rehab too is quite
the movement,
intense.
Whereas broken bones, doctors always say it'd be a lot better off if you just broke your leg or your wrist. So, yeah, it does. It comes... And it's all an experience. That's what I like about sport. It's these things are an experience. People are like, oh, man, breaking bones. But I'm like, it's an experience. Like, I know. Like, I know what a scaphoid is in your wrist because I broke the thing. I got a screw in it. Yeah. Like, I'm learning these things and I'm hanging it. Like, I'm on the operating table and Stephen Andrew comes in and he goes, oh, man, you're riding so good today. Shame you crashed and broke your collarbone. Count to 10 and I get to 5 and then I wake up. Oh, he's done. Like it's a pretty cool thing, but like it's just another experience in life. Like I've experienced those things. It's not I'm normal still. Just not in the head.
Who's that everyone knows Lance
Armstrong.
Yeah, Lance Armstrong. Yeah.
Tongue twister there.
He I read his book.
Yeah. Have you seen his movie? Like on Netflix? You
gotta watch it. Oh yeah, I've just heard about it.
Oh man.
And they filmed it as he was getting busted. Yeah. Right. And they didn't know whether to keep making it with him, but they actually did.
Yeah, well, there's one that's like they've got an actor in there and stuff. It's like a full on proper movie. It's insane to watch, like the whole thing. And the thing, like they did a survey, and a lot of the Olympic athletes, they said like if you could take drugs and just win an Olympic gold, and then that's it, like you died. Like they reckon that like 70-80% of people. Said that they'd do it.
Right, yeah.
Like, and that's what athletes are. Yeah. Like, hungry and set because they've done it. I've done it since I was 5.
Right. And especially when you're doing so much training.
Yeah.
You think of supplements and things as, like, just little things that might help me work because I'm already a great machine.
Yeah.
And, like, what is that bad? Oh, it's not bad? Okay, I'll take that. You know, I don't think it's that as much for the motocross guys. Yeah. What I was getting at, though.
Yeah, it's not for us.
On your point of breaking bones and because you guys break more than probably everyone.
Yeah.
Lance's book was really good. When he got cancer, it made me feel really good. Like, I hate that word, the C word, you know, can't stand it. But in his book, he explains how, because he was such a performance athlete, and he would study everything. So he went, okay, I've got this. All right, have I got the cancer? All right, no worries. Well, guess what? Bang. That's all he did was, like, think about it. Like, read everything about it, what these cells do, what's that, and he, like, could visualize himself getting better.
Yep.
So you've broken your bone, okay?
Yeah.
Here we are, Todd Waters. He's busted his collarbone. I'm sure you can visualize it getting better because you know what's broken exactly. You put these pins in, have your doc. All right, cool, Steve. Yeah. Excellent, mate. And you're on the road to recovery way better than the person who just goes, all right, dog.
Yeah.
Sort it out, mate.
And like you said, with rehab, like, the simple thing, like, wrist, I was in plaster with scaphoids, are insane. They get no blood
flow. That's a little one that every bike rider gets, right? Yeah.
And so when you break that, you're in plaster. I was in plaster for 12 weeks, and it was set like that. So when they took it out, I couldn't move my wrist. I thought, oh, my God. And they said, you'll have no movement. Like, you won't get movement back. And so I was going to hand therapist. Like, I went, like, two times or three times, and she gave me exercise and stuff. So like you said, we're obsessed. I'm just nailing those exercises. And I've got full movement, as you can see, like, same as the other one. You know, and that's what it's about. It's the other dudes that are just like, oh, yeah, physio told me to do this, like, whatever. You know, that's the important part. And
you can visualise the repair. Yeah. Right, okay, I know about that bone.
But you know what it needs to do. But you know what's going to happen if you don't fix it too. Like, if you don't do those exercises, you won't be able to do what you're passionate about.
It's pretty cool.
So where are we racing next? What's the next race?
Yeah, next race will just be some preseason races in New Zealand. And then, the big...
Interesting they don't race through the summer. Like, in a sprint car world, it's like a sister kind of deal.
Yep.
Because it's perfect to be racing all through summer.
Yeah. Well, I guess it rains quite a lot in summer.
Maybe in Europe and America.
No, it doesn't really. No, the start of the year it does. Like, February, it used to be like, you know, start of Feb. And, like, Coolum would always get rained out. I remember coming down from Cairns and we were stuck on the side of the road in the floods a lot of time in, like, Tully and these sorts of places. So, I'm not sure. I think that's the reason is, like, the weather side of it. But, our big thing, I'll just be doing the preseason stuff, going to New Zealand and doing that, just trying to get up to speed. And then we'll head over to America a month and a half before. So that will be around April. And then, we've got, it's just like bang, bang. It's 13 rounds across the USA. And it's, top of the game. Like, it's massive. So
the Honda team that you're racing for in America?
No, so we're going over to race for Honda. We got Honda support. And we're going over there. Similar thing to... Like I said, going over in 2012, showing them, you know, this is what I got, and getting a ride. So that's, we're going over there. Yeah, so we're going over, we're making it happen.
When you say we are going over there.
Yeah, well, that's how it is. I talk we as in the people that are involved in me. Yeah. So, you know, it may look like an individual sport, but it's not like, and that's just my personality as well. I'm not someone walking around, oh, yeah, oh, I did this. I always say
I'm sick, bro.
Yeah,
that's just cool.
How I am. Yeah. I'm like that, you know. Yeah, if I say we, it could be me and my girlfriend.
No, but I mean, when you went, what's your the team you're running for now?
Cranked Honda. So, no, they're finishing up. They're not running anymore.
That's what I mean to say.
Yeah. So, right. they're finished. They're, closed ship.
Okay.
And
they'll turn into something, no doubt.
Yeah,
no doubt.
Somewhere. I don't know what road. So...
So you're getting your own deal now.
Yeah.
Here we are. We've got a great rider. We're looking out for sponsorship to get over to America and race that series over there. Is that like the big series or is it a series within a million series?
No, it's the big dog. Like the
Say it again what it's called.
The AMA Motocross Championship.
Oh, shit.
What is it? AMA.
AMA. So AMA. American Chad Motocross. Reed. Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. AMA is like huge. The
The
biggest.
tell us for people like me.
Yeah, so.
American.
Motocross champ.
Motocross.
Let's ask Google.
Yeah.
Hey, Google. What is the AMA Motocross Championship?
According to Wikipedia, the Motocross Race Series was founded and sanctioned by the American Motorcyclist Association in 1972.
There you go.
Oh, that's what it is. American Motorcycle.
That's when I was born! High five, yes, yes.
Come on.
What did you say, 1972?
72. It's an old ass, grumpy motocross series. Right about now, it's getting pretty grumpy and tired in the afternoons.
No, so it's cool. Like, as kids, we grow up watching on TV. It's on Ozstar. It's like,
wow, have you done that series before?
No, I haven't.
Oh, shit, Todd. That's what we're come doing. On.
Yeah, so come on, mate. I went and did the World Championship, like the Europe side of it, and awesome. Like, you know,
Where's the money? I wanted to ask you before. Where?
Both, but America's where it's at. Like, it's the big. Like I said, they're not the World Championship, so they've got the. I don't know. Americans, they're like that in every sport. You know, they just, they know how to promote things.
Sprint cars far out.
They know how to make things look big and awesome and create a good show, and they bring sponsors. Yeah. And
Like look college at, football and stuff. It's not even really on TV, and they've got all the brass band. They just have a song about them.
Basketball, like, massive. That's how it is. And same with every sport. Monster trucks. Look at monster trucks, you know. Yeah. So that's where it's at. World Championship was a dream of mine. That's where Chad Reed went first. And that was I wanted to follow in his footsteps and experience that. And I met great people. I've seen different culture, all that sort of stuff. And AMA is like, it's a lot easier for the way of going over there. They speak the same language. It's it's really simple like that to do it. Championship's over 3 months. So what I'll do is I'll go over there a month and a half before, race the championship. And then I'm going to stay over there and practice for 6 weeks on Supercross. So, we explain the different tracks and bike setup. So, I'll change over, ride their tracks because they have massive facilities and tracks everywhere.
I imagine their Supercross is bigger than
our
Supercross.
Oh.
Like, their stadiums are...
Yeah. They sell out 80,000 people.
I mean the physical size of the track when you change setups and stuff.
Yeah. But it's more like the teams. Like, you know, you ride for Honda over there, they've got test tracks. Like, they're getting dudes changing the tracks, obstacles, to challenge you to make you bigger and better. Whereas QMP, the ride park, he said, like, me and my buddy Kirk got a track built out there, Supercross track. So we're riding that.
I was riding that today. I was trying to think of what it meant. Like an approach ramp or something? He got it made?
Oh, Kirk?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that was for the Motocross of Nations. So Kirk went and raced that this year, and he made a start gate.
Yes,
like it was like a raised gate.
Okay,
So that was like a
feature. I was trying to work out what they actually meant in that term. So I
So they imagine like the ceiling height, and they had like the start gates up there, and you went off and then dropped down.
Yeah.
So.
Okay. Yeah.
So is this AMA championship?
Yeah.
Is that like like if you're a tennis player, your ultimate goal is to get to Wimbledon?
Yeah.
So that's a Wimbledon of
Super.
Yeah. Wow. So you've made it.
It's
yeah, but to him as a racer, you're never happy until you're winning it, am I right?
And then when you win, you haven't won enough.
Exactly.
Oh, really? Like when does it end?
It doesn't.
It doesn't.
When you retire, you think, oh, I'm going to come back. No, it's true. That's just a fact. And I don't know.
But you've got to be pretty chuffed with yourself if you've made it to...
No. Why would you be chuffed? That's just getting a big head.
But I've got
too many good mates around to bring me back down to earth.
Oh, no. But, like, it is an achievement, you know?
Well, definitely.
Yeah.
Between us to be in the same room as this dude.
I know. Like, I'm feeling a bit special now.
100%.
No.
Yeah, but to him, I can understand the racer. Like, yeah, I'm in that top thing, but that dude is... need to beat him, you know what I mean? Like, it's never enough.
Yeah.
It's never enough. And that's why it's so cool, you know?
Yeah.
So can you really dumb it down for me? Because I really want you to pick up some sponsorship from this.
Yeah.
Because just like the many Aussies that have landed over there and had a go at stuff, you know, in all sorts of racing, people like you as a person.
Yeah.
But doesn't mean that... Bob's Diner is going to back you.
Yeah.
So it's really important that you take Aussie money over there somehow.
Yeah.
You know, like, because it's really hard for you to turn to the local American guy and they go, why do I want to sponsor an Aussie?
Yeah.
You know, so it's you got to make the biggest fuss here.
Yeah.
And you'll find, and the cool part about motocross is you don't really need as much money.
No.